Hello and welcome to day one of the 21-day Pray and Profit Prayer Challenge. Y'all, I am so excited because I know God is just up to something so, so supernatural. So like, I'm really excited about that. I'm definitely gonna pray for you, but I'm gonna give you today's assignment as well as what I just hear the Lord saying for you. So pretty much each day, I'm gonna give a key scripture that I want you to study. And this is the scripture, I'm gonna share the scripture for today, but when you're studying these scriptures, I want you to study it in multiple versions just to get even deeper revelation about it. And also ask God, like, what does he want you to get out of reading it? And like what he wants you to hear from it. And so I'm gonna give you today's Bible verse. And then I also wanna share what I hear the Lord saying. And then I want you to be mindful. So I'm actually gonna give you the assignment first because I think this is actually really important. So what I want you to do is, the assignment for today is to just pray and ask God what he wants you to get, receive, and focus on in the next 21 days. So what does he want you to get out of the next 21 days? What does he want you to receive out of the next 21 days? And what does he want you to focus on in the next 21 days? And so this may be specific to your business. This may be specific to your family. This may be like, God may be like, I want you to focus on being disciplined. Or God may be like, I want you to focus on, you know, time management. I want you to focus on watching your mouth and watching your words. Like, there may be different things that God may deal with you about. And so your job is to pray and ask God what he wants you to get, receive, and focus on. So that is that. And the second part of the assignment is to revisit the list of things that you said you were fasting from. Of course, you know that we are fasting from sugar. We're fasting from secular music. We are fasting from the list of things that's on there, right? That we all agreed to, right? When you join this fast. But I'm just gonna challenge you to go deeper. I'm gonna challenge you to really take it another step and ask God, like, what else do I need to give up? And so for me, I'm gonna be honest. First of all, I have a gluten allergy and I be playing, child, because let me tell you how I be playing, because I like bread and pasta. So I'm giving up gluten, like for real. I'm actually fasting from gluten. In addition to giving up sugar, I'm also giving up potatoes. You know, things that like, and this is actually a great example because I don't want to get this stuff up like at all. Like, I am not interested in giving these things up. And I think that's the beauty of fasting, is that fasting is like, you're literally killing your flesh and you're dying to your flesh. You're dying to the fact that you're dying to your flesh. And so one of the things I want to also say for y'all, like, as you're getting started, even if you have a moment where you mess up, so let's say I'm at a family barbecue or something happens and next thing you know, I'm eating, you know, wings with barbecue sauce on them, the sweet. And I'm like, oh my God, I just ate something sweet. Shouldn't have ate that, right? Thing number one is, okay, you messed up. Like, let's transition and do better. Like, you can always get back on track. Or some of y'all may have a moment where you're like, oh my God, I'm craving, you know, some candy. And then you eat some candy and then you're like, oh, I messed up. Here's the thing, just get back on track, right? But the first goal is to not fall off, right? Like, make that commitment to yourself, make that commitment to God. But if you do mess up, like, it's not the end of the world. But don't be that person that mess up and then the whole fast is off. Like, no, stay committed and get you an accountability partner too if you need one. Just to say like, hey, I'm fasting for the next 21 days. I really want to honor God. And the reason why I'm telling y'all this is because I know the power of prayer and fasting. Anytime I fast, when I tell y'all, anytime I fast, I see breakthrough. Like, I see God do something supernatural. So the fact that we're intentionally praying for our businesses, praying for our finances, praying for our lives, our mindsets, like, y'all, do you know what God is getting ready to do? It's about to be incredible. It's about to be amazing. And one of the big things that I have noticed when I fast is that even though my situation may not change in the moment of fasting, my heart posture does. Even though my situation may not change right before my eyes, my perspective does. My peace does. So I'm telling y'all, like, really pushing away the plate. And for some of y'all, I challenge y'all to go a little bit deeper. So it may be you may not eat meat for 21 days. It may be, I actually have decided that Monday through Friday, I'm actually going to do a Daniel fast. So I'm not going to eat meat during the week. And then on weekends, I'll eat meat. So there are things that I'm pushing away. And I just want you to be mindful and pray and ask God, like, what is it that you want me to cut out? What is it that you want me to sacrifice? Because these are things that you may not realize, but they're in the way of you hearing God clearly. Like, in the way. I'm a nerd, so I've done a lot of studying. And one of the things that I studied is, like, fasts in general, not just fast from a biblical perspective, but there are people that do, like, fast from just from a scientific perspective. Fasting actually brings mental clarity. So especially water fasts. So that's why on Mondays, so starting on Monday, okay, on Monday, on day three, the way that this challenge is set up, while it's running live, day three falls on April 15th. So on Monday and every Monday after that, until the fast is over, we will be fasting a water fast. And that means that all day for 24 hours, you're not eating anything. You're not eating any food. You're just drinking water. Okay. One thing I do want to mention for those of you guys who are fasting, and I'm going to get into the thing I hear the Lord saying, but I wanted to start with the basics. So for me, I have traditionally gotten, like, migraines, when I'm, like, depriving myself from coffee, or if I drink too much coffee. So some of y'all need to not drink coffee for a period of time. Like, there are all these things. But I have gotten migraines. And one of the things that really helps, I always like to share this because for me, and I'll link some stuff down below that is going to be helpful. But I use vitamins, different vitamins to keep, like, the headaches away. Because a lot of times when you're stripping your body of nutrients and food, like, you need to be replacing it. And so from a headache perspective, what really helps me is magnesium. So I take magnesium, and I also take CoQ12 or Q10. That also helps with, like, energy and, like, brain function, I think. Like, I don't know, read the label. But those are two that I did a bunch of research about and ended up finding out that those help a ton. Some of them, I think when you take it, you do actually have to take it with food. So if you are, you know, if you, like, usually I try to fast, and then if I start getting a headache, then I'll be like, all right, let me take my vitamins or whatever. And then I will, get some almonds, like 2, 3, 4 almonds, eat them, take my medicine, and then go back to fasting, right? Or take my nutrients and stuff and go back to fasting. In that same way, if you are the person that you have to take medications and things like that, please, please, please eat. But, like, don't be eating no fast food. If we fasting from fast food, eat an apple, take your medicine, then go back to fasting, or go back to whatever you said you were fasting from. All right, so I am going to share what I hear the Lord saying for today, and I'm really excited. So the scripture for today is 1 Corinthians 2:9. The version that I memorized, and don't ask what version it is because you can Google it. The version that I memorized and have memorized since I was in college is, no eye has seen, no ear has heard, nor has it entered in the heart of man that which God has prepared for those who love him. I am so excited about that verse. And again, I want you to really take some time to like do some study on it, look at different versions of the Bible, of what it says. And just the thing I hear the Lord saying is that this next season, you've literally like, your brain isn't even in the space to be able to like capacitate. Like you don't even have the capacity in your mind to believe what God is about to do. Like God is about to do like a new thing. Like, and oh my goodness, God is about to do a new thing. And it's gonna look better and more amazing than you anticipated. It's going to not just blow your mind, but you're just gonna be in awe. It's like your head is not, like your mouth is gonna be on the floor. And so in that, I just hear the Lord saying like raise your expectation, shift your perspective, because a lot of you all have been in a place where you've been like, but God, I know you said that you were gonna do X, Y, Z and I haven't seen it happen. But God, I know you said you were gonna, like you promised this in my business, but it still hasn't happened. But God, you called me a, you know, a millionaire or, you know, whatever the case may be for you. I hear a lot of y'all, like it's interesting because my prophetic voice allows me to get in the heads of people and their thoughts and conversations with God. And the thoughts and conversations are like, Lord, but like, were you serious? Like, were you talking about this year? Like, and God is like, you've been questioning my timing. He's like, you've been questioning whether I was gonna do what I said I was gonna do. And he's like, I am God and I do not lie. I cannot lie. Lies cannot come from me. And so God is like, this is a season where he wants you to see it before you see it. He wants you to see it. That's like, he literally wants your perspective to change. He wants your expectation to change. He wants your expectation to shift to what he said. And for some of y'all, you may be like, oh, this is, you know, pray and profit all about business stuff. Y'all, God cares about your personal life too. So for some of y'all, the things that God reveals to you during this time of fasting may not just be about, you know, your business. It may not just be about your finances. It may not just be about who you're called to. It may be about all of that. Plus God may reveal to you stuff about your home, your, you know, the what you drive, your family, your womb, your relationship status. Like there are things that God wants to talk to you about. And in this next 21 days, he's going to reveal so much. And I just hear him saying, like, literally raise your expectation, like shift your expectation. And a lot of what's going to happen in the next 21 days is the shifting of mindset, the shifting of expectation. And I just hear the Lord saying, lean on me, lean on me, lay your burdens down, lean on God. Lay your burdens down. Everything you're worried about, everything you're trying to calculate timelines for, God is like, lean on me. Lean on me. Don't worry about all of that. Lean on me. Don't worry about all of that. Because no eye has seen, no ear has heard, nor has it entered into the heart of man that which God has prepared for those who love him. He has something so amazing and incredible in store for you. Like, I don't know if you can feel it. If you can feel it, I need y'all to type down below, like, I can feel it. Like, I can feel it. I feel the shift coming. I feel my help coming. I feel it. I feel it. I feel it. I need y'all to type that down below, because when I tell you, like, man, God is up to something, and God is like, you've been so worried about where you've been and the struggles you've encountered that you, like, all of that has distracted you from what God's promises are. And God is like, baby girl, just look up. Just look up. What do you see? Like, he's trying to show you something. He's trying to show you that, you know, like, he wants you to see it before you see it. But, like, you have to, like, the thing I love about this verse is that it says, no eye has seen, no ear has heard, nor has it entered into the heart of man that which God has prepared for those who love him. And, other versions talk about the mind not having been able to imagine it. And it's like, God wants you to see what he's going to do, but what you're going to see isn't going to be as big as what he does, right? And so that's why God is like, no, I want you to shift your mind, shift your perspective to what is going to come without it making you feel like, oh, I'm not where God wants me to be yet. Oh, I'm not where I want to be yet. So some of y'all going to have to make, like, some of y'all going to have to fast from complaining for the next 21 days. No complaints. That's for somebody. I think we all need to do that, okay? Catch yourself. Stop complaining. Stop looking at your situation now. Because I feel like what's happening is when God tells you what he's going to do, and because you're not there, you're like, well, I'm not there yet. So then you start complaining about where you're at instead of having gratitude for where God has you and being grateful and being like, Lord, I am so grateful for where I am now. And I'm looking forward to where you're taking me, right? And so let's shift out of complaint. And I'm not giving you this funky face because I'm judging you. I'm judging me too, okay? I ain't judging nobody. I'm not judging myself. But I got the same energy for myself. Like, let's stop complaining. Let's make a commitment that we're not going to complain over the next 21 days. And when we catch ourselves complaining, we're going to be like, ooh, ooh. And we're going to find something positive to say. So if I'm like, ugh. Like, I'm going to use one of the most common ones, bank account, right? Ugh, I just can't wait to, you know, because sometimes we be using these fancy complaints. I can't wait till I could, you know, have, you know, donate $30,000. Or I can't wait till, you know, I could actually have the money to do that. Like, and it's like, are you really saying you can't wait for that? Or is that a hidden complaint? I can't wait for the days when my bank account is in the negative. Instead, be like, Lord, I am so grateful that I have everything I need today and that you're going to allow me in the future to be able to have, you know, give $30,000 to organizations. You're going to give me the opportunity in the future to not just pay my rent and my mortgage, but pay rent and mortgage for other people, right? And so one thing I do want to say, y'all, I have ADD, so these videos are going to be all over the place because it's going to take me where I need to go. But the other thing I hear the Lord saying is that many of you all are big dreamers, but you haven't been dreaming big enough. And some of y'all are real big dreamers that other people have convinced you that you're crazy. And God is like, no, you're not crazy. So this is a space where we're going to be dreaming bigger. We're going to be thinking bigger. When we are having activities and assignments, like, the goal is for you to think big and to think much bigger. So I'm going to share something really quickly that I feel the Lord telling me to share, and then I'm going to pray. So for those who don't know, my name is Candace Janae. I am a digital marketing and automation strategist and business coach. I'm the CEO of Epic Fab Girl, clearly, where we help Christian women entrepreneurs. And I'm a girl from Chicago. And, you know, I started Epic Fab Girl in 2016, but I had started working a corporate job in 2014. So straight out of college from 2014 to 2017, I was working a corporate job. And so while I was on that job, God started talking to me about, like, you know, calling me off of my job. He started talking to me about my, He started talking to me about my influence in entrepreneurship, how he had called me to have dominion in the marketplace. He started talking to me about a lot of different things. And one of the things that he always said, and this was around like 2015, was that I was going to operate in, like, literally, I have a prophetic word that I listen back to often where the woman literally says, like, you know, go and get that journal that, like, you used to just write all these ideas down in, open it up, dust it off, and, like, focus on an idea and get started with it. And she was like, God wants you to dream bigger. He wants you to think big about the anointing that is on your life. And she literally was like, you're thinking too small. You're thinking, like, she was like, God is telling you that he wants you to operate in an international marketplace. Like, you have an influence, and you have an anointing for the marketplace internationally. And she started to say, like, he wants you to operate in international business arena. And so, mind you, in 2015 when I got that prophetic word, I'm sitting there with my mouth on the floor like, what? Like, not international business. And so that was like a really big thing. So, you know, but I could see that, like, you know, I saw it. I'm like, okay, God, you call me to international business. And then as years have gone on, people are like, I really see you having influence in Europe. I see you having influence in the UK. I see you having influence in all these places. So it's like God would show it to me, speak to me, confirm it. But then I would see it for myself. But then in my reality, I didn't see it. So fast forward to like 2018, 2019, after I started Epic Fab Roll, we had an international audience. We had clients that were in our membership that were in London. We had clients who were pretty much from all over, and pretty much with our virtual services and the things that we did, we got a lot of clients that were international. So now, even now, we have clients in the UK, we have clients in Nigeria, South Africa, Kenya, London, Paris, Amsterdam, the Caribbean. Like, we have clients from all over, and I was able to see that manifest in my life in, you know, when it began to happen. But I still didn't fully take seriously, like, the call that was on my life for an international marketplace arena. I just thought, oh, you know, it's digital, whatever. And then at the beginning of this year, at the beginning of 2024, I got another prophetic word from someone that was like, you know, I really see you going into the UK and like Europe. And it reminded me of that prophetic word. Now, many of you guys may know Joanne, who's a part of our community. And she is actually based in the UK and has been asking me to come to the UK, host events. And my brain just wasn't connecting the dots. Like, my brain wasn't connecting the dots with all the prophetic words and what God had called me to, and, like, you know, my clients actually wanting me to come to the UK. So with that being said, what ended up happening this year, in February for my birthday, I was like, oh, like, you know, well, in December of last year, I told my team that I was like, hey, you know, like, I think we're gonna host an event in like London in June. Like, that's something that we wanna do. And I said that because I had went to London for, I had went to Paris right after Thanksgiving of 2023. I went to Paris with a friend, and she was like, oh, let's take a day trip to London. And when we were in London, the hotel we stayed at, I was like, this is a really nice hotel. I wonder if they host events here. And so I literally like went to see the hotel and the conference space. And I was like, oh, I think like I would like to use this as a conference space, for my events. Like, this is really, really nice. So that was in November. In December, when we had our team meeting for the year, I literally tell my team, like, we're going to do an event in London. And they're like, oh, that's amazing. Everybody's down. I'm like, all right, cool. So we plan to have this event in June in London. So in February, February rolls around. February is my birthday month. And I had been trying to figure out what I was going to do for my birthday. Long story short, the Lord provided for me to be able to go to London. Like, I found a flight to London. I was like, oh, I'll spend a week in London. And so I decided to spend a week in London. And I was like, oh, I'm going to do a meetup with our clients that are in London. And let me tell y'all, like, this is no eye has seen, no ear has heard, nor has it entered into the heart of man that which God has prepared for those who love him. Because I was just thinking like, oh, I'm going to go to London and I'm just going to do a little meetup with like our clients that are in London. So I send out an email, I set up a landing page, you know, a sign up link for people to sign up to like meet up in a coffee, like in the lobby of a hotel. Do you know that over 100 people signed up? I said, wait a minute. We got 100 people that are in the UK on our email list that are interested in showing up. Like, my mind was blown. I was like, okay, God. Okay. All right. I hear you. So we end up hosting this event. Like, y'all, I did not plan on editing this video, but I have to edit this video just so I could show y'all what happened in London. Like, it was crazy. Like, these women showed up and showed out. So we ended up actually having to put together an event. I threw together an event in under a week's time. Like, I decided I was gonna host the event. I booked a venue, like, did all this stuff in a week's time. And like, the craziest thing for me, I'm not gonna cry, but the craziest thing for me is that people showed up. Like, I am a girl from Chicago, Illinois, where when I got to London and went to dinner with some of the ladies in London, they were like, "You're well known here." I'm like, "What?" They're like, "Amongst the Christian women entrepreneur community, so many people follow you. They love you." Y'all. So I'm telling you that even when God shows you, it's still going to be bigger and better than you imagine. And so we were able to host this event in February, and then we are turning around and hosting a conference in June in London. And when I tell y'all, like, I am so excited about what God is doing. And I'm excited about what God is doing in my life, but I'm also so excited. I get so excited about the calling on the lives of the people that God has called me to. So I am excited about your journey. I'm excited because I know that the people that God has called to me, like, y'all are a big deal. Like, God has so much in store for you. And when I think about all the things that God wants to do in my life, I just know that so much of it trickles down in the lives of those that he has called me to. So when I tell y'all, I'm so excited, I'm ecstatic, and this is just the beginning. Like, the fact that we're taking on, like, this event in London, like, a girl from Chicago, like, y'all, you have no idea. I'm just so excited. And I am looking forward to what God is doing and wants to do. That is my testimony, is that, like, when God does a thing, it's just better and more amazing than you could have ever imagined. So no eye has seen, no ear has heard, nor has it entered into the heart of man that which God has prepared for those who love him. And that includes you. So let us pray. Whew. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. Lord, we thank you that you are a sovereign God. Lord, we thank you that you are a holy God. Lord, we thank you that you are a mighty God. Lord, we thank you. We thank you that you are bigger than our mind can even fathom. What you have for us is bigger and more grand and more amazing than our minds can even take in and think up. Lord, I thank you, God, that your word literally says no eye has seen, no ear has heard, nor has it entered into the heart of man that which you've prepared for those who love you. And so, Lord, I thank you that you are preparing something so incredible, but our minds can't even wrap ourselves, we can't even wrap our minds around the concepts that you're going to do in our lives. Lord, I just pray, Father, that during this next 21 days, that these women's lives will be dramatically transformed. I thank you, Father, for the woman that's listening to this that needs breakthrough. I thank you, God, that you're going to bring breakthrough in her perspective, breakthrough in her mind, breakthrough to her finances, breakthrough even in the area of peace, Lord. I pray right now in the name of Jesus that you would give each and every woman that is listening to this the understanding that of what she needs to focus on, set her intentions on during this next 21 days. And I pray, Father, that you would show her, show her, show her, show her, and Tell her what she needs to give up, what she maybe hadn't considered that she needs to actually release and let go of. And so, Lord, I just thank you, Father, that you are doing supernatural things. Lord, I pray that you would give her the ability to stick to what she says she's sticking to during this fast. Lord, let her not retreat and resort back to her old ways, but let her die to her flesh, Lord, and let her crucify her flesh consistently. Lord, I pray that you would give her the ability to watch her words, give her the ability to be careful with what she's saying, and not complaining, but instead pursuing life and the things that come her way with a place, with a mindset and a outlook of gratitude instead of just complaint. And so I just thank you that you are doing a new thing. I thank you that you are covering her in all things, and I just thank you that you're ordering her footsteps. So we just thank you for all that you're doing. I thank you for the peace that surpasses all understanding. I thank you that you're giving her this supernatural grace to fast in this season, and that you're just gonna do a new thing. So we just thank you. We praise you. We worship you. Lord, we thank you for the incredible things that you're gonna do in her life, not just during this fast, but beyond it. So we just cover her. We thank you. And I just pray that you would have your way. In the mighty and matchless and holy name of Jesus, I pray. Amen, amen, amen. So I will see y'all tomorrow with another message for tomorrow and assignment. So make sure that you open up your emails and put us on the senders list that you're going to receive emails from. And so we are just so excited and grateful that you are spending your next 21 days with us. All right. Love ya. Bye.